Welcome to part 2 of Resident Evil 4 Remake, folks.
Sacrificial lamb, you will receive our most sacred body. Begins now. When day breaks, you two will join our covenant to share in my holy blessing forever.
Condor 1 to Roost. Do you read me?
Condor 1? You've been radio silent for 3 hours. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Won't let it happen again.
And the church?
Still looking for whatever key I need.
Copy that. I'm glad you're okay. Roost out.
It's time to begin Chapter 4, folks. Leon just really had a bad dream over there, literally. Sadler was turning him into one of the Ganados because of the dream. And also, we're inside of that torture chamber after going to the docks. And we're in the valley, folks. Get Pesetas. Of course, rare items usually drop occasionally, you know. Yeah, you can hear chanting in the forest. Crouch. And we got a parasitic enemy coming out of the dude's head. This guy, he's really annoying. He can easily shave your health off. Gotta kill that guy. Head just exploded. Yes, these Ganados. Yeah, these Ganados randomly explode their heads, and this torch doesn't break. You know, those parasitic head kind of reminds me of the anime that I watched in 2015 called Parasite. Good show, you know. Now we're going to the cave.
What is this place?
This is a shrine.
Some kind of shrine.
Yes.
Same mark from the church.
It is.
It's the lake.
Yes, it is the lake. We need to investigate two locations, folks. Can you shoot this one? Of course you can. Old Way Shrine Key. And kick that barrel. Egg hunt. Someone fetch me a rare gold chicken egg. What will I do with it? Well, sometimes it's more fun not knowing, right? I'm gonna go onto this boat. Press L2 to reverse and R2 to accelerate. I'm gonna use those spears to save up my ammo. But all I gotta do is craft some items. I need some machine gun ammo, shotgun shells, and also we need to use the TMP for the shortcut. And don't drop my frames already! Darn it! It's not cool! And we gotta kill that big lunker. Missed, Leon! a Lunker base. All this does is carry up 8 spaces, you know. But yeah. Anywho, let's sell that to the merchant. Let's sell this Lunker base to the merchant. I recently got my COVID shot last Wednesday. But last Thursday, I really had a really bad headache and pain.
Welcome. I've got something new for you.
Here, I'm gonna sell some grenades.
Ruby's all rubbish. It makes no difference. The price, well, that's our choice. Perfect. You're a real professional.
And let's buy the recipe first.
We've been saving that one. Right, customer. Well done. Come back anytime.
I don't want to have to get the blue note. So I had to kill the Lunker base first. Let's kill that fish. Can't destroy it. Now let's go and get that chicken egg. Black base, large one. And let's heal. It's a chicken island. Good lord. That's a lot of chickens. And pick up the velvet blue. Wow. Now can I actually reload? No, I don't need all the chicken eggs. The gold egg will let you restore a large amount of health.
I'll be taking this.
Yeah. We'll probably go back for that. Now let's give that to the merchant.
Hello, stranger.
Wow. The merchant, by the way, is voiced by Michael Adamwaite, who did Ray Penver from Death Note. He's a Byakuya from Inuyasha, The Final Act, and Dr. Gakari from Mega Man NT Warrior.
This is what I'm talking about. Fine.
Now let's buy the case upgrade, 8x12. Cool. Now we can go on that boat and do what we have to do. something very important. Wow. Perfect. That knife doesn't really help, so shoot that boy. Another velvet blue. They are twisty sons of bitches, Leon. Got him. Oh god, he's still alive. Got them. Gotta burn that Molotov scumbag. Gotta unlock that door from the other side. This axe-throwing bastard just doesn't know when to stop, does he? He's still alive? Oh god. Get away from me! Get away from me! These guys are pretty good at shaving my health off. A dynamite? Are you serious? I'm seriously need to use my flash brain grenades to finish you off. Ha! Huh. The parasite's weaknesses are bright lights. Watch out for that dynamite. Why get when my frames drop? There's a treasure up there. Shoot it and get the velvet blue. And pick up the yellow herb. Gotta combine it. Thank God I got more ammo. Reload. Let's deal with him first. And don't touch the friggin' fire! Oh no! I remember that one episode of Parasite when Migi just decapitated a parasite head. That was an episode 2 of Parasite, that anime I watched. Because Shinichi killed one of the parasites. A dog parasite and what else? One of the mincemeat murders was a parasite. Even Mr. B and Mr. A. And Reiko Tamura was a parasite as well. a female parasite. She can shapeshift into a teacher and Shinichi's mom. She just killed Shinichi's mother in that anime. Oh, God. But anywho, folks, we gotta do that puzzle. Let's see here. Top left, top right, and bottom. Open up the door so that we get Apostate's head. Wow, these heads do not appear in the 2005 version, literally. And oh my God, blood is coming out of the statue's neck hole. It's a bit odd. And we're also gonna run into more Ganado villagers coming by. Ready to lose his arm, but he can still attack you no matter what. Well, not his arm, but his hand. Alright, we're good to go now. Let's check. No, I think that's all there is to it. We gotta go straight so that we can go to another island. Well, not another island, but another dry land. Because there's the Way Shrine. Gotta use those spears to destroy the torches. I don't understand why there's like infinite numbers of spears. What is he, Moby Dick or something? I don't know, but I digress. And let's use that Way Shrine key. Splendid Bangle. Jump on that ledge and get the Alexandrite, because this is where I shot the treasure case in Chapter 3. Hop on, Leon. Oh Lord. All I gotta do is destroy that torch. Cool. But first of all, I should probably get some fishes. There's four of them. Four friggin' fishes. But for right now, I gotta check. And yes, we need to go to another cave. No, I don't need the other eggs. Imagine if Wesker, my idol, would say, "You will give me an egg!" Well, Wesker's actually my favorite character because he's awesome. I love his power. And there are three fishes that we gotta farm. Okay, just go onto the ledge first. Yeah, these torches are not unlittable. They're not breakable either. Sometimes torches can be unbreakable. But you know, we got a puzzle, folks. See, left, bottom right. This opens up and we get the hexagon piece. And second, the Blasphemer's head. Now it's time to get the key to the church first. Now we can get our fishes. My stuff's totally full. Way to go, Leon. You crashed into a wall. I gotta sell that to the merchant. Well, no, I'm not gonna go to the merchant yet. First. But first, I gotta place those heads there. Place the apostate's head there so that the handles will move. Place the final head here. That way we can get the insignia. Ta-da!
Condor 1 to Roost. I found the key to the church.
Copy that. Now go get Baby Eagle.
Right. No time to chat. I'm going in. Condor 1 out.
For the love of God, Leon, stop with the bird code names. You're making Hunnigan look awesome, you know? What is this, Top Gun? But I digress. Now we gotta go sell those fishes. We gotta head to the docks, to where we saved Lewis last time.
Thank you. Might want to take care of any leftover errands before going this way.
We are not gonna leave until we get all the treasures. Technically going to this shipwrecked area. Why is this big wooden boat left behind? Alexandrite. And also Red 9. It's a different type of pistol. Definitely got a send that to storage for now. Wow, more barrels to break. Stand still, damn it. Cool. You can't break that obstacle. Okay. I actually gotta kill these stupid punk Ganados. In here. That's the way. No, use the old way shrine key so that we can get the pearl bangle. Oh, jeez. Ow! That burns, idiot. Oh, he tore his limbs off. Just great. Totally great. Now we're gonna use the insignia key one more time. When you use all the keys, they become valuable so that you can sell them. And that blue note just disappeared. And when we go in there, there's a corpse of a young lady. Why is her face covered in blood? And they made a Los Illuminato symbol on her face? Oh my god. Now we're gonna climb. And there's a small key located to where that dead girl from the opening of chapter 1 was. The small key is on the carriage. Kick that barrel. And get the green herb so that we can combine them. That way we can get the full health upgrade. And also we're gonna run into new enemies. The brown Comillos. These guys are annoying. They got a parasite on their backs too. And their parasites can slash at you and shave your health off. Man, I don't like those guys. They're very damn annoying. Darn right I'm serious, dude. Oh my god, cut it out with this parasite thing. That hurts. You can't parry. Those Comillos move literally fast. Okay, shoot that. Let's get in there and use this small key so that we can get the type of treasure called Golden Bar. Perfect. So this is where Luis was held captive last time. Let's pick up that book. Old Man's Journal. 3 years ago, my beloved daughter passed away shortly after giving birth to a son. Since then, the boy has grown considerably. He is a very curious child and has a true thirst for knowledge. He even tries to follow after me when I go out hunting. I can't take my eyes off of him for a second. Whenever we walk in the forest, he always asks me to tell stories. He's very fond of Don Quixote. Although he's still small, the boy's smart and observant beyond his years. If he weren't stuck here, he might have become a scholar. I was a careless fool. I could have sworn I shot clean through the wolf's head, and yet it lunged at me. I was able to make it back to the cabin, but my wound is swollen and discolored. I cannot bear seeing the boy's worried eyes. My body moves on its own, and I can't hear voices inside my head. Am I going mad? I can't die now and leave the boy behind. Dear God, please protect him. And also, we get the red gemstone ring, so that's excellent. You know? Please climb up, Leon. And by the way, I haven't mentioned this to you, Lord Sadler, Osmond Sadler, is now voiced by Christopher Jane. But in the 2005 version, he was Michael Go, who does Dan Smith from Killer 7. He was Yugo Ogami from Bloody Roar Primal Fury. And yes, Michael Go did a very good job doing the voice of Gopher from Winnie the Pooh. He's awesome. So basically, we are going to have to go... I'm going to check one more time to see what we got. From now on, let's head to the stone pedestal. Again? I forgot. Forgot to get the treasure in the small cave shrine. Sorry about that, folks. Sorry. And also gotta get the rifle ammo. Gotta get more ammo. That's much better. Now it's time to head to the stone pedestal. Let's see if there are any fishes nearby. Nope, not anymore. So I should probably go over there to the fish quarry and get more fishes and vipers so that I can sell them the hexagon piece here and solve that puzzle. Bottom left and top. Booyah! We get Depraved Idol. Let's see if we can find some vipers. There's a crow up there, shoot that. Hope he doesn't drop anything. No, of course he doesn't. And shoot that nest. When you shoot a nest, items drop. They drop items. We gotta kill five more vipers. Here. That's two. Heard a viper. Come on. Thank you. Where the hell are the vipers? Oh, I see something jumping. Friggin' fish. Okay, keep looking anyway. Oh, gotta heal. Okay. Oh man, snake. Boom. Let's see how many more we got. One more snake to find here, folks. There's another. No, thought it was a nest. But it's actually moss. How's a snake stuck on the plank? Oh my god, I really hate vipers. Snakes give me the chills in my spine. The creeps. Something hissing is what I heard. It's probably six. Ah! I don't need that knife. No. It's a friggin' snake. Where's that little sucker? There he is. I had to kill six of these and four fishes. Finally. Okay, now we can sell those.
Take a look. Welcome. Wilde, what can I do you for?
Don't sell the splendid bangle right now, Leon.
Much good in the grave. Thank you.
Gotta love the merchant's cackle.
Try that on for size. Dazzled, are you? Our crops. Starting to get, might want to take care of any leftover errands.
All right, folks, now we're in the quarry. Time to use the old way shrine key for now. We get the butterfly lamp. This carries circular recesses. You know?
Shit.
Gloria a las plagas. Gloria a las plagas.
Jesus Christ!
El Gigante. This guy's very annoying. He's gonna roar at you, and he's gonna slam you, kick you, and he's gonna ram into you. If he grabs you, he's gonna squeeze the life out of you, because if you don't escape from him, he's gonna kill you instantly by biting your head off. No, it doesn't matter how much health you got, you will die instantly from him, you know. When he's knocked down, melee attack that punk. That worm punk. And he also lifts up houses. Oh wow, it's the wolf. Reminds me of Okami. Yeah. Ow! Stop smashing me. You hear Okami barking. I'm gonna name him Okami from now on. Cause Okami's a Capcom game. Shoot that parasite on his back. Way to bite him in the back of his foot, dude. So if I didn't save that wolf, it would be a lot harder. And look! That El Gigante just ran into a wall and he got hit in the head! Keep firing that idiot. Booyah! Goodbye, El Gigante.
Goddamn. That was almost a pancake. Okay. Let's get to that church.
By defeating El Gigante, we get a golden diamond. And I have to mention this. The El Gigante can also throw houses at you just to get your health shaven off. And Leon just said, "God damn, I'm also a pancake." I love that line. Yeah, you would be at Denny's or at IHOP or at a Waffle House for a pancake. You know? And the El Gigante would have you for breakfast. But I digress. We only got 9 more treasures left, folks. Let's count. 1, 2, let's see here. 3. Four. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Alright, we got 9 more left, folks. Pick up the handgun ammo. Red-robed cult just chanted so he could summon the El Gigante? But in the 2005 version, these Ganados try to open up that door and the El Gigante just killed them. Oh my god. Okay, let's go inside and kill that snake. That freaking viper. When you break a crate, a snake will appear and he will start to bite you in the neck. Well, not in the neck, but in your face. Watch out. Oh crap. More Comillos.
Alright.
It's a way to kill those annoying parasitic punks. Yeah, gate's closed. So let's place the church insignia here so that the gates to the door will open. Excellent. Let's get inside. And we'll pick up the small key for now. Pull down that lever. But before we do the puzzle, why don't we go over there and get to the drawer where we found that map last time. You got the yellow diamond. That's cool. Oh, gotta combine them. Excellent. Needed that. Gotta open up those cabinets. Get more ammo. And kick the barrels. Get more money. Open up that other cabinet so that we can get the blue dial. Bolts. Let's place the blue dial here and solve that puzzle. Gotta make sure that this matches. That these colors match, you know? By completing the color puzzle, we unlock the door. Yeah. Now let's go up there and save Ashley.
Ashley, you in there?
Okay, I'm gonna kick those barrels first. And also, that's Ashley's cell phone. So that means we gotta go into that storage room and save her.
Ashley. Ashley Graham, are you in here?
Just let me go.
Listen. Easy with that.
And that was Ashley Graham, who is now voiced by Genevieve Buchaner in this remake. But in the 2005 version, she is voiced by Carolyn Lawrence, folks. And that's the end of Chapter 4, ladies and gentlemen. And let's go on to the next chapter for now.
Thank you.
time for chapter 5, ladies and gentlemen, and watch out for those Ganados. Been spotted. All we gotta do is escort Ashley to safety. But before we go and go up there, we better get inside that storage room and get the treasure. Get the yellow diamond, Leon. And also, we got 3 yellow diamonds right now, so that'd be good. We should combine the splendid bangle with... This is square! It's made out of 2 squares, duh! 2 friggin' squares. These Ganados are a bit annoying.
Get the ladder.
Gotta make sure that Ashley gets that ladder, folks. So that she can drop the ladder down for me. And also, you don't want to look at Ashley under. But in the 2005 version, it was really funny. She will say, "Hey, what are you looking at?" And she'll go, "Oh, you pervert." Doesn't happen in this one. That's a bit odd, you know? But if Ashley dies, mission failed. In the 2005 version, I remember Ashley getting killed by one of these enemies. And Leon will say, "Oh, no." Now let's get out of here.
No way.
It's okay, I've got you. Hey, trust me.
She's afraid of heights.
Thanks.
Okay, you press R3, right? Well, not yet.
Bruce, I've secured Baby Eagle.
Copy that. Is she okay?
Affirmative.
Well done, Condor One. I'll dispatch a chopper ASAP. I'm sending you the coordinates for the extraction point. Make your way there, and don't let anything happen to Baby Eagle.
Copy that.
Hurry. The weather is getting worse. Roost out.
Wow. So many bird code names. Time to head for the extraction point. Before we head to the extraction point, we got some side quests that we gotta do.
Like I said, it's dangerous. Stay close.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Gotta hold the X button so that Leon can move the cabinet out of the way. You press... Let's see. When you see... On the bottom right, you're gonna see Ashley and Leon. Press R3.
Spread out.
Okay.
To spread out. Press R3 again to stick close.
No problem.
Alright.
Okay. It's alright.
If Ashley gets incapacitated by getting hit by enemies or bear traps... When she's incapacitated, if she takes one more hit, she dies, and the mission fails. That's no good. And these Ganados can carry Ashley, because if these Ganados take Ashley away from Leon, far away, mission will fail. That's no good. Gotta do is take out those Ganados so that they don't take Ashley. They've been infected by these parasites, Ashley. They are twisty. Ashley's got 0 defenses. That's pretty weird. But in Resident Evil 4 2005, Ashley had health. You can also heal Ashley with herbs and stuff. but not this time. Just ran out of freaking TMTs. Yes, I'm freaking serious. Excellent. Let's hope there's nothing else in there. Yeah, you can actually go back on the ladder so that you can get the jewel. But I already got the diamond anyway, so that's fair. We need to head to the village chief's manor now that we've got Ashley Graham. Oh, I forgot to share that with Ashley first. That cell phone thing that just broke. Let's see how she reacts to it, shall we? Frames are dropping. Come on, get over here. Sigma Gamma PHI? You just brought that phone. I mean, who could ever shoot Ashley's phone? Seriously. No, don't stop, Leon. Please, stick to the mission. Yeah. When you go over there, Ashley doesn't say anything.
Come on.
No problem.
Yeah, you can hear Ashley go, "Where are you going, Leon?" Yeah, when Ashley gets taken by one of these Ganados, she will scream. You let out a piercing scream. An annoying squeal, you know. Shall we get some more ammo? And resources. Technically, I gotta get more TMP ammo first. Probably need to save my ammo for tougher bad guys. Die, you twisty son of a gun. He's got a Molotov. Oh, fudge! Way to go, Leon. You big idiot. Didn't mean to call you an idiot, Leon. You're smart. You're a smart guy.
I've got some new items. Welcome.
Let's see if we got new items, shall we? I'm gonna get the bolt for her. But right now, I need to sell the Splendid Bangle. And the snake. I hate snakes. Seriously hate snakes.
Your valuables won't do you much good in the grave.
Oh. Whatever you say, man. Whatever you say. And get the bolter.
I'll hand this over when you've got the space. Not only will you need cash, but you'll need guts to buy that.
Yes, I do need guts to buy the weapon. And we got something new. A savage mutt. I need someone to get rid of the wild dog that's been roaming around the village. It'll be easy to spot. It's not like normal dogs. You wouldn't mean like these strong Comillos? Which means fang in Spanish.
Sorry, we need to keep moving.
No, we can't take a break, Ashley. Look, that big-ass skull. Hope it doesn't scare the crap out of Ashley, you know. Well, it did. I mean, it would. If I ever see one of those skulls, I would scream. Seriously.
Hunnigan was right about the weather.
Yes, she is right, Leon. You would probably catch a cold. A way to alert those enemies by destroying those torches, Leon. Good thing I got rid of all those skulls. But right now, we got more Ganados to fight. I'll have to slash the living shit out of you guys. Why don't we? Ow! That's hot! Ow! Yikes! Shaving my health off. Ugh. Okay, that hurt. Okay, I should probably use the grenades. Right? No, flashbang grenades. I don't have that yet. Yes, I do, but I don't have the large resources, that's for sure. Seriously? Why is her arm on fire? That's odd. Well, seriously, it is. Of course, we gotta get to that barn over there. Gotta get Ashley inside so that she can unlock that the two doors from the other side.
I need you to open it from the other side.
Yeah, Ashley, I need you to open it from the other side. Seriously.
Okay.
Good work.
Thanks. We get the elegant bangle. Looks different. And also, let's head to Mendez's place and get that treasure. And don't drop my frames. Oh wow, we've already been in there, so that's fine. I know you're upset, Ashley, so get used to it. You could have gone and worn a raincoat, Leon. Time to head upstairs. Oh, this is where I got that pearl. Jeez. It's dark in there, so you can easily get lost. Take that picture frame out of there. So that it will reveal a lever. Pull it down so that Ashley can go up there and pull down that ladder for me.
Come on.
We're going in the attic, folks.
What is this place?
That's the attic. So that's where we shot that Castellan. Village Records, Volume 2. All the men cheered when they heard the boat as it raced across the surface of the water. That magnificent oil will surely help us catch fish easier than ever before. Ironworks was only built a year ago, but has already merged well with the village. Our sickles and knives shine like never before. The two fish we caught from the deal will eat almost anything, are breeding well. The fish farm in the swamp is also making excellent progress. During the day, I teach literacy and mathematics to the children. Every evening, I dine with a single family to hear their grievances and recent gossip all over the roof of this home we built. Since I opened the village up to the outside, we have prospered and the other people are happier. Smiles have even started to appear on their faces. A strange group of black-robed people descended upon the village from the castle and raised an ominous flag with a spire-like insignia upon it. After preaching about salvation and forgiveness, they injected us with something they claimed will cure us of madness. Can they be trusted? No, they can't be trusted. They are cults, you know? Look, Chief Mendez's father. A father's portrait. Watch over the village in my steed, and may smiles always find you in photographs. Why is it in Spanish? That's a lot of photographs. And chests. Photo of the factory, the long-awaited ironworks, 1992. Duck. Village record number one. Elder entrusted the village to me today. He told me I can learn my duties as I go. I will start by keeping a record of the village. There are still many words I cannot write, but the elder encourages me. I will do my best. There is a young boy who lives in the cabin by the lake with his grandfather. It seems that his mother was called to heaven upon this birth. His grandfather doesn't talk much, but the lad is very bright and spirited. He told me a story about a knight who rides a donkey again today. The boy's grandfather has fallen ill, and his condition worsens every day. The boy worries terribly about him, and there are murmurs of a madness among the villagers. As I took my leave, the old man pulled me aside and said, "If anything happens, you know what to do." I could only nod in response. It was a terrible night. Everyone stood around the cabin and watched as it burned to the ground. The boy looked on without saying a word. Even as dawn broke, he didn't move a muscle. The next day, he was gone. Oh, God. That's another picture. Photo of a boy and his grandfather. The Navarro family, 1981. Antique camera. Ta-da! We're out of this. Let's reload. Path's blocked. Oh, God. There's no going over there. Just go to the front and look. We got a big Comillo guy. Very annoying. That's a strong threat that the merchant was talking about. So all we're gonna have to do is kick the shit out of that wolf. Well, that infected wolf, that is, that big one. By shooting it, literally. Hi there. Gotta make sure we kill him before it. Oh my God. Now knife that sucker. Still alive. And he jumps like a... By defeating him, we get Alexandrite. So that's good to know. We should probably look into those houses and find some items. Whoa! Okay, gotta kick the barrels and get more Pesetas. The first aid spray. Perfect. Now can I combine? Yes! Thank you! Now let's save the large resources for later. Just in case. Got him. But. Let's go in the back. No. There's nothing else here. Oh my god, he's about to transform. No, literally, he is.
Here you go.
Give me a warning next time.
You heard him. I mean her. Die, you old freak. We've already been there recently. That's fine. Hopefully we're gonna go for another way shrine area. How many treasures we got left? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more left, folks. 5 more to go. Would totally agree. Oh look, 2 cows. Do not let those cows hit Ashley. Piss off! Okay, those cows can literally hit Ashley. A brute? Not him again. And he's about to punch Ashley. Die, fatty. And we get the emerald. I hate the brutes. Ha. You can't break that? Impossible. You know what? Kill him. That's unbreakable too. Honestly, how many? Yes, I know. But we're gonna use the old way shrine key. To get the. We got another antique pipe. That's the second time we get that. Or probably a third time. I don't know. You can't destroy those. And don't kill the pigs, and don't kill those bulls. They don't drop anything valuable. Now we can go talk to our merchant buddy. And tell him the good news.
I knew I could count on you. What can I interest you in? Thank you.
You're so welcome, man.
Take care of any leftover errands before going this way.
Of course. I gotta craft.
Be ashamed to live the rest of your life wondering what it
Seriously, let's see if I can snipe that torch, right? Can you snipe that torch? Come on. Seriously, do. Too far. Can you actually shoot it? Oh, of course not. That's a waste. Lewis! Hey, buddy.
Señorita.
Sí. senorita has a name, Miss Ashley.
Name's Luis. Encantado.
Great. We all have names. Now then.
Who are you? What are you doing here? Very good questions, unfortunately.
Hide, now.
In that case, here, help me.
Ashley, quick, over here.
Go.
Fourth wall breaking moments. Game time.
Heard something against two of us. Oh, and let's not forget, this one is made up of monsters. Done warming up? Hope you stretched.
Yeah. Now if you'd shut up, we'd be good to go.
All we gotta do is put those wooden planks on the windows while we hold off these Ganados. Get some resources there. They can break cabinets and even windows. And also, in the hidden cutscene of Resident Evil 4 in 2005, when you shoot Lewis three times, he gets really angry and he will say, "Adios, Leon," and he shoots Leon, killing him instantly. It doesn't matter how much health you got, you know. Gotta get rid of these punks. Okay, I need to try using the bolt thrower first. Press L3 to use mines. You hear beeping? Anyone who steps on them gets ripped in half. They explode. Why are you pushing me for? Hey, nice parrying, man. Oh, he just knocked the friggin' picture frame.
Are you trying to kill me?
No, I'm not trying to kill you. Sorry about that. And we got the wooden planks. Hey, are you trying to kill me? Not me, them. That's one of my favorite lines. Yeah, do not shoot Lewis, ever. But in this one, he doesn't say adios, Leon. Literally, he doesn't do that, honestly. No, not bad at all.
Out of the way.
You don't want to waste your duration of your knife. Next. More wooden planks.
All right, this one's good.
Now they're gonna do the ladder. Right after we put the windows up. Yeah, I knew it. I knew it. Now let's go upstairs and take out the ladder. Let's hope there are plenty of items that I can hear. Nope. Yeah, I can thank you later, right after we deal with these Ganado punks. Look at these guys chanting. Shut up! Oh man. Let's hope I craft more objects, shall we? Now I gotta craft. These enemies usually drop herbs. A brute? With a big hammer? Yes, we do. You're not rude. Got the ammo. Ow! I parried!
Early stage the parasite, the plaga. It is possible to remove it with the surgical procedure. And all you need is some know-how.
Oh yeah, the right equipment.
Wait, you too?
No worries. See, I have a plan. But you're going to have to trust me. Great, we're partners then.
Hey, why are you...
No time for any questions. The clock is ticking.
Why are you helping us?
Because it makes me feel better. Let's leave it at that. We'll contact you later.
Chapter 5 is completed, ladies and gentlemen. I can't believe Luis just had a scar on his chest after the surgery from the parasite. When Ashley is infected by the parasite, she coughs up blood. Literally. We're on to the next chapter. Chapter 6. So, let's go!
Hey. Got a smoke?
I do. The kind you like. Now where's the amber?
Unfortunately, it's not on me at the moment. And you really should be telling me what a good job I did. Busted my ass and managed to hide it right before I got caught. Which is why I'm still alive.
The deal was, we get you out of here when you deliver the amber. No amber, no protection, Luis.
Such a stickler for details, huh? Okay, then. I'll go get it now. How about that? And I do have something else I need to get, too.
This is Roost. I've got some bad news, Condor One. With the weather like this, the chopper can't make its approach. Can you stand by until it clears?
Negative. Too dangerous. We're gonna get out of here and find someplace safe.
I'm sorry. I wish I could do more to help.
Don't worry about it. We'll swim home if we have to. Condor One, out. Let's go.
Alright, folks. Time for Chapter 6.
Right now. Let's just focus on getting out of here.
You swim your way? That makes no sense. You can't even swim, Leon. You'll probably drown. But anyway... Merchant tip, midnight stroll. You ever seen those nasty guys with the tentacles sprouting out of their heads? Not only are they dangerous, but they're a pain to kill, too. They do have a weakness, though, that they absolutely hate bright lights, like the sun. That's why you won't see them out during the day. So if you ever go for a walk during the night, it'd be wise to keep some flash grenades handy. Hell, I keep a couple of me at all times. You can make something... You can make yourself... No. You can make some yourself using the recipe I am selling if you're interested. Let's see what we got.
Welcome. I got something new for you.
A red 9 stock? No thanks. I don't need that right
There's
now.
Some things money can't buy.
I'll take the high power scope. Why not?
You're trying to thread a needle with a bullet there, mate.
Probably not.
Molding a weapon. See how that feels, mate. Fella like yourself should notice the difference right away. We're starting to get an idea of your tastes, friend. Will that be all, then?
I'll repair.
Easy work. Come back anytime.
My health really dropped. And there's shotgun shells. Of course. And there's a note. Tighten the defenses. This is a direct order from Lord Siler himself. Convert the area beyond this point into a defensive position so that no intruders may pass. I am willing to make any and all sacrifices for the sake of the righteous faith. My devout believers, build me an impregnable fortress and make sure they are... any heathen foolish enough to trespass pays for their wicked sins in blood. Oh, wow. You can shoot this one, right? No, you can't. They're unbreakable.
We've got company.
Yeah.
Quietly.
Got it. Oh, Jesus. When they sound the alarm, I can hear that bing, 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 and then a brute will come by and attack me. I hate the brutes. Ah, nice parry, man. Yep, I knew a brute would appear. Those brutes kind of remind me of the big man Majinis from Resident Evil 5. Oh god. You got Molotov. All I gotta do is blast that bitch up. There we go. Now get the yellow diamond. Why the heck? Another Molotov? Seriously? You're dead, lady. Yay. Seriously, yay. Okay. I didn't lay those gems. Had to do it. Had to do it. Yikes! What are those parasites? What is that weird looking? She's alive? Are you out of your freaking mind? Yeah, you gotta shoot those bear traps. Not them again. Just watch your footing, okay? Better make sure that Ashley doesn't get incapacitated. Because that would be no good. Let's count how many more treasures we have left. Three more left. That takes care of him with a grenade. We got a Chalice of Atonement. That thing's totally combinable. So that means we gotta put, let's see, probably like four emeralds here? Well, three emeralds. No, those aren't Chaos Emeralds from Sonic the Hedgehog, you know? They're just normal emeralds. Because if they were Chaos Emeralds, it will turn Leon super, you know? Yeah, all those torches are very bulletproof, you know?
Sure, it's quiet.
Too quiet, if you ask me, Leon.
It looks like I need something.
Yeah. You can't light out that torch. Look! Yikes! Hiesta means there it is. Ow! Piss off, you stupid fire dude! Where'd he come from? Door's locked from the other side. So that means we need to find another way. Look at all those clothes. Shoot that. No! I keep telling you, Leon, stop wasting your bullets. Now we gotta get Ashley in that locker.
What?
You heard me, Ashley. Stay in there. Okay, put the old way shrine key in there so that we should get elegant headdress. That's another one of these. Let's see how many more we got left. I'm gonna be looking for the last treasure over there. Still bulletproof. Don't worry about shooting them. Let's look over there and see. No, apparently not. But I gotta craft my weapons. Well, not my weapons. Items. at the first aid spray. You can't call for Ashley yet. Door's locked.
Won't open.
It's locked from the other side, Leon.
It's locked.
So that means we're gonna have to pick up this crank. Oh! Ah!
Great.
Oh God.
It was yours. I am flattered. But I'm a one lady type of guy.
Oh god, not these chainsaw sisters. Those chainsaw sisters are kind of annoying. They're gonna be using the fuck you chainsaw to kill you instantly. So be careful. Doesn't matter how much health you got, you will die instantly from that chainsaw attack. Yeah, they can appear over there. They're insane! They're both worse than Dr. Salvador. Than the Chainsaw Man. So the Chainsaw Man is also known as Dr. Salvador, right? They're actually the Bella sisters. Run, Leon, run! I seriously hate chainsaw enemies. What is this, Texas Chainsaw Massacre or something? Female sisters version? Another parasite. Good grief. Alright, we got a sapphire and a checkpoint crank. Yikes. What, Ashley? Oh God. That takes care of one of them, Ganados. He just got caught on fire screaming. Literally. But who cares? Anywho, now that we defeated these chainsaw sisters, we got the crank. And it'll put the crank here. This is a metal hand crank used to open the checkpoint gate. Just hold the X button.
No, I'm okay. Yes.
You did well back there. Seems this isn't the first time running from creeps.
I can't tell if that's meant to be a compliment.
It's not a compliment. It's just normal. But yeah. That was an insane battle. If I ever did this on hard mode, it would take a lot of bullets to kill those sisters. Those Bella sisters. Okay, let's go into the window. Well, not the window, the hole under the roof. Get some more ammo. Flashbang grenades. We should probably hold on to these just in case. More gunpowder. That's a whole lot of skulls.
All right. Come on.
Okay.
Not Mendez again. Ooh. You have to run away from Mendez, folks. Because he will chase you. Because if he grabs you, he'll probably kill you instantly. Well, he reminds me of that of the Tyrant from Resident Evil 2 Remake. Or the Nemesis, you know. Whatever you do, do not worry about those Ganado punks. Make sure you shoot those TNT barrels, but don't get too close to them. Because that would hurt. Okay, we gotta head over there. The bridge broke. It exploded.
Okay.
I'm stuck.
Need to go. You gotta be kidding me.
I'm good.
They're broke.
Wow. Ashley just got stuck. Literally.
Listen, you're the one he wants. If we see him again, you run.
What about you?
I'll do my job.
No, Passar. No means no trespassing. Oh, great. Probably need to get some more shotgun shells. 12 gunpowder and 1 small resources, you know.
Gun welcome. Got a selection of good things on sale. This kind of work is about finesse, stranger. Little bit goes a long way.
Oh, look, a riot gun. Semi-automatic or shotgun with a tight spread, making it effective at a longer distance. Okay, folks. Now we're gonna be heading into that thing called, is that a barn or something? I think that's the, what is this place called? The slaughterhouse. All right. Now I gotta use my shotgun.
Be careful.
You heard Ashley. Be careful.
Give me some space.
Got it. I'll stay back.
Oh my god!
Leon!
Cease your pointless struggling. Abandon your body to the will of our God.
You're a shitty missionary. You know that.
Oh, Almighty. Grant me the strength to crush your enemies.
Son of a bitch. Ashley, run!
Okay.
Hasta luego.
God, I thank you for your gift.
Oh, God, he's transformed.
You want to get ugly? Let's get ugly.
You want to get ugly? Let's get ugly. This battle is going to be very annoying. You know, he is one of the bugs. He's going to use his big claws to attack you. And when he grabs you, he's gonna impale you and shave off your health. You gotta press the circle button to evade his swipe attack. Press L1 to parry. He's gonna use his left claw to strike at you. Make sure you shoot that eyeball.
You think you could be this fool?
No, I'm not. And he lost his limbs. Oh, God. Then he grows claws this time. That's even more annoying. He climbs onto these bars. And also, it's gonna be... Guess your tap dancing days are over. Love that line. But, yes, he's gonna be throwing firewood at you and slash you. When you throw, and yes, also gonna throw fuel barrels at you. Because those fuel barrels will definitely shave off your health if you don't shoot those. Back at you. You have to avoid these planks that he throws at you. They're firewood. Why is he throwing so many firewood at me? No way. Then he's gonna lunge at you with his scorpion-like claws. Well, he kind of almost looks like one of the scorpions from Resident Evil Zero. But I digress. I think this is one of the best boss battles of the game. Whoa. Sorry, I had to jump over. That freaking hurts. Why do you keep swiping claws at me, dude? What is wrong with you? Quick, finish him off, Leon. Really? You're gonna keep throwing more fire at me? Then he gets faster and more angry. Let's hope he throws a fuel barrel. No, I won't die, you friggin' jerk. Okay, enough with the firewood throwing and stuff. Ow! Son of a gun! Now I gotta heal. That's much better. Now I can use this. That freaking hurts. What the heck is wrong with you? Come on, reload! Ew. We can escape from the slaughterhouse, but first we'd pick up Mendez's false eye. It's a treasure item this time, but in the 2005 version it was a key item. So by defeating Chief Mendez, we get Mendez's false eye. Yeah. Let's see if we can find more items. I'll be right with you, Ashley. Be patient while I find more items. There were two ladders? Good lord. Didn't have to worry about getting the shotgun shells, but whatever. Leon,
Thanks. This fire's bound to catch their attention. Let's keep moving.
Leon, I'm not going to turn into one of them.
I won't let that happen. I promise.
Yeah, right. You're welcome? I love that line. Alright, folks, we're gonna go after the last treasure after escaping from the slaughterhouse that's been on fire. And yeah, we got the emerald. Let's see. That's it. All 39 treasure have been collected. Easy enough. And also, you can shoot those, right? No, you can't! That's a waste of bullets, you know.
What's going on?
Well, at least we don't have to worry about being followed. Come on.
And that's it for Chapter 6, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you in Part 3, where we're going to do Chapter 7. So see you then.